This is Stampy, and welcome to a Minecraft Let's Play video, and another video inside of Stampy's lovely world. Good morning, William Beaver, a very good morning to you, and good morning to Fizzy Elephant. And I knew you were here, Fizzy Elephant, because I kept hearing a door opening and closing just before I started the episode, so I knew you were somewhere close. Good morning, Fizzy Elephant, as well. Right then, let's go and start off by eating my breakfast. Nom, 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 nom. Very, very tasty. Bartleby, you can stand up. You can stand up. Can you stand up? You can stand up. You can stand up. And you can follow me, and we are going to begin. You know where we're going to go. I don't need to tell you where you're going to go. If you don't know where we're going to go, and this is the first video that you've ever watched, then you will soon find out where we're going to go. But most people know where we're going to go. Right, we're here. So, today to the Love Garden, I am going to be adding Ella. The reason I'm adding Ella is because she drew this picture, but it's not a normal picture. It's a Christmas picture. You can see me there standing in the North Pole, and there's the Christmas tree. You can see Duncan and Mince down there. There's a cake, there's a snowman, and if you look in the background, you can also see my lunar friends flying past in their UFO. Really reminds me of my Christmas last year, so thank you so much for the amazing picture, and welcome to my love garden. And oh, I got a carrot. When I get the carrot, I was looking at the picture, then I look back up, and I got a carrot, and everyone's gone. Oh, hello, Fizzy. There you are. I got an egg for you, Fizzy. You can have that there. Right then. Let's go to the doghouse. I want to be quick today. I want to drop off Barnaby, choose which dog's going to be joining me today, because we're starting to build a brand new minigame. And it's a pretty big one, and a pretty, I don't want to say complicated, but it's going to be a long day, isn't it? You know you've got lots of digging to do. You want to save your energy. I built that bench, I don't know how long ago, and I don't think I've ever seen anyone sit on the bench. I'm like, no, carry on. I'm not telling you off. It's good, because I feel like there was a reason for me building the bench. Actually, there is a reason for that bench being there. Here's a little secret. If you jump off the bench for now, William, the reason this bench is here is because it's actually like covering up redstone, which I wasn't smart enough to be able to fit in. So the only reason there's a bench here at all is one to be a secret stash for Fizzy's cookies, and also to hide some redstone that's down there. Anyway, someone feel free to fix my bench if you want. There we go. That might be something that a lot of people watching this didn't know. But right then, let's choose which dog's gonna be joining me. I think Benton, you can join me today, and Barnaby, you can come down over here with Duncan, and you can sit down and you can spend the day with all of the other doggy friends. Barnaby? Where did I saw him a second? There's Benton. Where did Barnaby go? Barnaby! But he's right. Barnaby, you can join us. Obviously, he is being stubborn today, and he's like, no, I don't want to be with them. I want to be with you. But no, he's out here. I left him sitting down out here. He's enjoying time at the bench. Right, Barnaby, you can stand up, and you can join me as well. Right then, let me go and show you where we're building and tell you what we're building. So today, we are building with magma. And I've not ever built a minigame with magma. Have I built a minigame with magma? If I have built a minigame with magma, it's not a memorable one, because I can't ever remember building a mini game with magma. So the idea of the game is that you're going to go around on a magma floor, and if you don't know the way that magma works, if you stand on it, it hurts your feet, as you would expect. If you crouch on it, for some reason, I don't know why this makes sense, but if you crouch on it, it doesn't hurt you. So the game is all about moving around on the magma, kind of completing goals while trying to stay alive, basically, because you want to move fast, but if you move too fast, then you're going to die. So you have to be really careful. So I guess it's a little bit of a dangerous game, but also hopefully going to be a fun game. So the main thing we're doing today is, well, the dangerous part. We're doing the giant magma floor and kind of getting the main arena of the game done, and kind of what the outside's going to look like. And then in future episodes, we can go and kind of get all the mechanics on and go a little bit more in depth exactly how this game is going to be played. So right then, you guys can go and sit down there and you can keep each other company, and I'm going to start building it. So this is where the entrance is going to be, down here somewhere, and it fits in perfectly with this little area here. Look. Right next to the town. Town Funland. Town Funland. It's funny how I've just built the town further and further this way, and now, like, it's basically just like one big town now, the Funland and the town. Anyway, I'm rambling. So, the color scheme we are using, we have brown, red, orange, and yellow. And then we have a bunch of magma blocks as well, seeing as we are building a magma game. So, I'm going to start off with the orange side, of course, which is where the entrance is going to be. And this needs to be 5 blocks in. So, this is where the middle of the game is going to be. I marked it with a poppy as usual. So if I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then it's going to be past here. So we've got a gap of 5. And then the entire side is going to be 31 blocks along, which means I just need to go 15 in either direction. So I do know because I worked out that the game fits in this area, that going 15 in this direction means the last block should be here. And then going 50, actually, I'm going to double check this one because it's a little bit weird with the way it fits in. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Then the last one's magma. I think this is right. Yeah, because look, it's 3 blocks away from here, but then it's going to go back this way and only going to be 2 blocks away from there. So there we go. I think I've done it right. So let's go and build the other side. So helpers, you can kind of join in and help now. So on this bit, I now need to go 15 blocks along here. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and then, 15. And then this is the middle one here. And then Fizzy, I mean, it's kind of helping, but not really. Oh, yeah. Yeah, do you want to dig out all that way? Yeah, that would be really helpful. William, go to town. Just go Fizzy as well. Just dig away. Get rid of all of this area in the middle. That would be really handful. Because the game's actually going to be 1 block underneath the ground as well as the way I designed it. So now we're going to have the next color. We're going to use brown for this one, I think. And we need to do the same thing again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And then the last one here is going to be 15. And then, okay, yeah, this is the end, Fizzy. Oh, that sounded very dramatic, didn't it? Fizzy, this is the end. I mean, this is where the back of the minigame is going to be, is what I was trying to say. And then we now need to go 15 blocks with the brown again. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Was that right? Oh, that's not magma. And I'm using an axe to break away wall because I'm crazy. Right, I can kind of check if this is the middle. Oh, I think I went one too far. Like, the game kind of lagged just a tiny bit. I'm trying to just line it up with what it is on the other side, or I'm going to hurt myself here. Oh, no, look, I'm crouching, so I'm not hurting myself. All right, let's just walk, and yep, that looks lined up nicely to me. So what color haven't I used yet? I haven't used yellow. So as you can see, all of the colors that I'm using are basically the colors of magma, which is good because colors like brown and that, like, I don't really use all that much. Like, normally, I'm looking at big kind of primary contrasting colors, but these ones all kind of just fit together quite nicely, and I really like the look of them. So yeah, the fact that it's a magma game is really going to make it stand up, and it's going to be pretty huge, by the way. I know it's like looking quite big in terms of it on ground level, but it's actually going to end up going up pretty tall as well. So it's going to be overall kind of one of the bigger games, and I think, like, judging by just the mock-up that I did of it, I think it's going to be hopefully one of the better looking games. I did do a whole behind the scenes, like, kind of mini series of me designing this game, and that's going to be on my second channel once I've finished building it here, if you want to go and check that out and see how I came up with the idea and kind of what the game could have been before I ended up changing it and kind of how I ended up designing it. But yeah, this is the way that it's ended up looking. So here we go. I mean, that took quite a while, but there's the outside wall of the game design. But yeah, once I've kind of placed down this outer row, the rest is going to be much easier to go and fill in. So Fizzy, can you kind of help me out building up the walls while William goes and carries on digging away the ground? So this used to, if you don't know, this used to all be water underneath the ground down there. So I did have to clear out the water, which was annoying. The good thing, though, is for what we're doing now is that we kind of just have the big pit down there, which is good because, as I said, the game is going to be slightly under the ground anyway. And also, there is going to be a little bit of redstone under the ground. There's not going to be much, so most of the redstone is going to be above the ground, but there is going to be a little bit underneath the ground as well. So that all makes it much more handy. So right then, let me go and try and actually now properly explain what this game is going to be and the way it's going to be played, because I realize I haven't done that. So it's going to be called Mag Match, because you're trying to match an outfit of clothing, and it's Mag Match. It works really well, and I got to give credit to Squishy, because she is the person who came up with the name. It's just too good of a pun. Like, I come up with lots of puns, but none of them are good, so you can tell if it's a good one that I probably didn't come up with it. I stole it. So yeah, it's going to be called Mag Match. So everyone enters the game. I pull a lever, and then that is going to be setting off the armor, which is going to be randomly dropping, and I think I've come up with a really cool way to make the items completely randomly drop. You have no idea where they're going to be dropping from. Well, there's going to be droppers, so you're going to have some idea, but you're not going to know which drop is going to find. There's going to be loads of them. There's going to be like, I think there's going to be like 32 or something of the droppers dropping out. So there's going to be loads of them. You're not going to know where the next armor is going to be dropping down from. You need to run around. There's going to be four armor stands, which you can see I have in my inventory now. And then you can put the armor on the armor stands. The thing is, if you put armor down, you're not allowed to take it back off. You need to commit. And the big twist with the game is that whatever helmet you put on your armor stand, whatever color it is, any other armor you put down, which is the same color, if it matches it, then that means you're going to get double points. So you get 1 point for any armor that's just on the armor stand anyway, and then you get 2 points if it matches the helmet. So it's all about matching it and making sure you try and get the right armor. And also, if you see that, you know, for example, I see Fizzy Elephant is trying to get blue armor, I might try and steal the blue armor to stop him from getting it. Not because I don't like him and I'm trying to be mean or anything, just because it's it's the point of the game. So yeah, that's going to be the way it's all going to work. So it's all about choosing when do you want to sprint and when do you want to crouch, because if you sprint, you're going to get hurt. But if you crouch, you're going to go slow. So you kind of really need to time it perfectly. And there's also going to be a few bonus cakes, which is going to be inside of the game. And the reason for them is just to keep your hunger up. So hopefully no one will actually end up dying. So right then, this is kind of what the game is going to look like for here. So let's go and start building the entrance then. So around the inside here, there's going to be one giant kind of row of magma. And this is kind of part of the game. You can jump up and like stand on this magma if you want. And there's another little trick that you can do if you want to try and get around faster. And that is, oh, not that, is if you stand right on the edge like this here, and then you can stand up. And look at this, I'm not getting hurt. If you go right on the edge, you can still stand here but not get hurt. And you can even sprint like this as well, but you've got to be really careful. And of course, you can kind of only do it around the outside of the room, so it's not the most useful thing, seeing as most of the armor is going to be falling down kind of closer to the middle. But it's just an added little strategy. If you can kind of do it well and you do see something on the other side of the room and you want to get it before anyone else does, then it's going to be definitely a worthwhile thing to do. So Fizzy, yeah, you go and help me do around the outside here, and then we need to fill in the entire floor in the middle here with just magma, one block down from the rim that we're doing. And I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, Stampy, you said that this game is going to look cool, and if the entire floor is just made out of one block, that's going to be really boring, and you can't have it as another block because it needs to be magma, so you get hurt. But don't worry, I have thought about that. I have planned ahead. And so I realized that if you put down, oh, hello, Fizzy. Oh, look at that. That was my last block, Fizzy. I placed what, Fizzy, you've done. You're finished. he gets such in a zone when building. He just carries on. This is actually going to be tricky building, so we have to do the whole thing crouch. But yeah, what we're going to do to make it so we can decorate it is we're going to use carpets. If you use carpets over the top of magma, basically it makes it so the magma still works like magma, as in it will really hurt you if you go and walk on it. But it means that you can kind of, you know, make it look like whatever you want, which is going to be handy. It'd also be good if people try and pick up the blocks, because it's kind of making the game lag a little bit. There's like piles of dirt all over the ground. I've got a double chest outside next to the top port assault course, so we can kind of dump some of the dirt inside of there if our inventories are getting filled up. And oh, sorry, William. Sorry, I just covered the staircase as you arrived. I'm sorry, that wasn't intentional. Yes, we can dump some of the stuff in there, and it's also got a bunch of spare magma and stuff as well, which is going to be very, very important. So right then, let's go and start getting the floor filled. And actually, tell you what, while my helpers go and start filling in the floor, I might go and start doing the ceiling, which is going to be another really important part of it, because we do need to have a bunch of torches. So something else which is cool about magma, I feel like I'm trying to sell magma. I keep like talking about all of its amazing features. I feel like I need to give you a card and say, hey, call me if you're ever interested in getting some magma. It's amazing. You can put carpets on it. It can light up. Yeah, that's what I was going to say, though. It can light up. So when it gets dark, it kind of, well, I say it lights up. It's not an equivalent of like torch or a glowstone, you know, block or something like that. It has a slight glow to it. It doesn't really light things up very much, but it looks cool. And so that is kind of one of the best things that's going to make this place look cool, is the fact that there's all of this glowing magma. But we are going to need to add some torches above. So let me just sprint a little bit and try and get outside of here. And let me go and do a little bit of a start on the roof. So there's actually going to be two floors. You're only going to play the actual game part on that floor. But above here is where all of the behind the scenes and all of the redstone's going to be. And then the reason we've built so far away from there is there's going to be like a little entranceway where there's going to be a doorway leading into the middle here. And there's also going to be a ladder going up to the top, because even though I'm... Whoa! Was that... Ow! Gotta be careful! Even though there is going to be... what was I gonna say? There's going to be a ladder going up, blah, blah. I don't know what I was going to say. So what I was going to say is that, yeah, even though you only play the game downstairs, you are going to need to go to the second layer to reset the game. So the redstone, I do think it works really well, the way that the, you know, we're using it. And it kind of fits what we're doing perfectly. But the game does take a little bit of a time to reset. But I think the games are going to last quite a while as well. But yeah, I've not tested it. As always, I test like to make sure the game is going to work in some way. But it's not like we go and like play the games like loads and loads in my sketchbook world and then like, right, it's perfect, let's build it in my lovely world. I always kind of like to have the first tournament as the first ever proper time playing the game, because then we can see, you know, the first time we played the game, who won? Who was the best? You know, before anyone's had any proper time to practice. And that does mean that sometimes we end up kind of changing the game in the future and kind of improving it, or I don't know, maybe sometimes making it worse depending on the way you like it. So yeah, we haven't had a test of this game yet, so that's why I'm always so excited to the first time we can kind of begin working out what it's going to look like. So the way it's going to be, this is basically kind of the same as the bit underneath there, and then the actual ceiling is going to be above here, and then that is going to be made out of wool rather than magma, and then that's going to be where the floor for the next layer above there is going to be, and then the carpet is basically going to fit with the same color scheme that we have down below and kind of be in the same way. But let me go and do at least a bit of a start on the ceiling here. So this is going to be orange on this side here, of course, and basically I need to go as far along as I did on the outsides down there. So it's basically going to be like a giant square of orange wall here for the ceilings. And then we're also going to have some beams kind of going down kind of on the same height of these, which is where the torches are going to be. But yeah, seeing as I'm going to go and start filling in a whole load of the roof, and there's still a lot more of the floor to fill in, I'm just going to go and speed up the video now until we've got most of it filled in. And then I can kind of do some of the more finishing touches details that we need to do down below. Okay, so as you can see, we have pretty much got the entire roof in, and it's good because it's starting to get dark now, so I can show the glow and you can see, like, you know, there's no torches down there and it's still pretty glowy. Like, once all of like this roof is filled in, it will get pretty dark down there, I'll be honest. It won't be, you know, bright enough. And I'm sorry, dogs, I know you're looking all sad here, but there's an entire room full of magma and I just don't rate your chances of survival in there. Sorry, this is definitely going to be a no dog zone. You're better off out there together. I feel less bad because I'm not leaving one dog. But yeah, look at this. There's no lights in here. It's actually glowing pretty well. And the good thing is as well, is that most like mobs won't spawn on the magma either. So even if it is a little bit dark, like none of the googlies are going to be spawning down here anyway. So we should be okay. We should be okay. So all right then, let's go starting in some of the carpet. We'll make a crafting table. Oh, where's my... Oh, I do have wood. I don't have any wood about it. I normally have oak wood, but I'm carrying birch wood at the moment. So I'm used to like scrolling to like a really specific place, but then I had to go somewhere else. Actually, you don't even need a crafting table. What am I on about? Don't even need a crafting table to make carpets. But yeah, let's just go and make a whole load of carpets. I've just made a bunch of orange. If you guys want to go and make... And I'll make some red as well, because I've got quite a lot of red wool on me as well. So let's go and make a whole bunch of this. And then yeah, we're basically, once again, keeping with the same pattern. So the weird thing about the way that we're doing this is normally it would be like it's the red team and the blue team and the green team. And careful, William. I guess with a full set of diamond armor, you can ignore the magma a bit more. So it does protect you. Having armor does protect you. Also, if you here's another magma fun fact. I'm full of them today. Is if you have Frostwalker boots on as well, then that also allows you to walk on magma. Or if you have a fire resistance potion as well. But of course, all of those things are going to be completely banned inside of this game. I will not even wear my Stampy style boots because that would give me a very, very tiny advantage, and I want to make sure it's fair. But yeah, so what I was going to say is normally you'd have like the red team, the blue team, the green team, but the armor stands are actually going to be down here. I kind of break away where they're going to be. No, Okay, I'm going to have to fill this in with magma. But yeah, they're going to be kind of like in between two of the colors. So to be fair, it probably makes it a little bit more confusing than it needs to be. Because, you know, I'm going to say like, right, I am the red-orange team. And they're the orange-brown team. It makes it a bit more confusing. But like, as long as everyone remembers what armor stand, like their own armor stand is, then it's going to be fine. Like, it's not going to matter too much. It's just a little bit weird way to do it. The reason I did it that way is because I just think it looks cool. I just like the design of this place. So maybe it was the wrong way to go about it, but I think it looks pretty cool. So right then, that is one of the quarters of the wall filled in. So there's then going to be a gap of magma in the middle here. And then on this side, there's going to be just the same kind of carpet fitting in with the same color scheme. And as you can see, if I stand up, the carpet has absolutely zero protection from the magma. So even though it doesn't look quite so dangerous, it is definitely just as dangerous as it would have been anyway. So let me just go and build this red carpet to the middle here, just to kind of mark exactly where it'd be. Well, I guess I can kind of mark the outside lines. This is going to be the very middle of the game there. I'll go and do this going down to the side there. Then I'm going to go and add in all of the armor stands, and then also some of the lighting as well, because it's a little bit dark here. So there's going to be some beams going across the ceiling. I guess, seeing as I'm over here now anyway, I guess I could go and start adding some of them in. So yeah, there's going to be beams kind of going across here like that. Then what that means is that we can just basically add torches to the side of these beams to light up the area. And it just makes the whole place look a little bit more interesting as well. There's no other purpose to these beams than that. But yeah, it's very important that you can see what you're doing. Seeing as there's no windows and it's not an open game, like I always kind of neglect lighting a little bit. But this is quite a good example of how, like, you got to choose between walking slowly or kind of jumping around. But yeah, this is where the armor stand is going to be here, and it's going to be the same in all of the different corners. But once again, seeing as I'm here, let's go and start filling in these beams going to the middle here, and we can go and start spreading around some of the torches in all of these different areas. So it's going to be, as I said, a bunch of droppers. So in each area, there's going to be, actually no, I think there's going to be 9 droppers in each area. So that means there's going to be, was it 36 droppers in total? Which is even more than I think I said earlier. So there's going to be a whole load of droppers absolutely everywhere, and you're going to have literally no idea which one's going to be firing the armor down left. So it's not going to be a case of like, you know, oh, you're in the orange section and someone's in the red section and then someone's in another section. It's like everyone's going to be running around absolutely everywhere. Like all that matters with the sections is that's where you're going to start, and also that's kind of where your armor stand's going to be. So I need to get the middle of here. Does that look like the middle? I think that's the middle there, and then I'm going to do a torch here and then a torch on the other side there. And then I could also go and add some torches around the outside of the walls here as well, just to light it up a little bit more, because it's really cool when all of the torches are added in, because it kind of looks almost like a, I don't know, like a magical cave? Is that going to be an apt way to describe it? I think magical cave, maybe like a dragon's cave or something might be a good way to describe it. I think like, honestly, like you look inside of here and then you compare it to even mini games that have a similar design with kind of like the lines in the middle and the different colors, just by using the magma and stuff, it just completely transforms the room to almost make it almost like a completely different style. And yeah, I don't know why I haven't kind of built out with magma much before, because I think it looks really awesome. So speaking of magma, I have run out of magma, so let me just go outside here. And as you can see, if you sprint and jump, you can actually move a surprising distance without getting hurt too much. Like if I do this, like sure, I'm getting hurt. I couldn't do this for forever, but you can kind of get around pretty speedily. And of course, I do have my my stampy style boots on, so that's kind of, you know, allowing me to not get hurt too much when I do get hurt. But it is a viable option not to be crouched the entire time. So I think it'll be a lot of crouching around to get your health up, and then kind of standing up quickly to kind of sprint around in that way. I think that's going to be like the most effective way to play the game. But yeah, I guess we're going to have to wait and see. But anyway, let's go and put the armor stand down there. And oh, there is one other thing which I haven't mentioned, and that is going to be, well, apart from the starting mechanism, is there's also going to be buttons on each side next to the armor stand. And all the buttons do is set off some redstone under the ground, which is going to set off some note blocks, which is just going to make a bit of a ding noise. And that's just to let everyone know that you've finished your armor stand. Because remember, the game only ends when one player, doesn't matter who the player is, once any player has finished their armor stand, they then ding the ding, press the button. And then that means that the game is over for everyone. So you want to be careful, because you could hold on to your armor and not place it straight straight away just to, you know, to make sure that you don't commit too early on to a color when you could have got another color a lot more. But if you do that, you're kind of risking it, because if it ends up being a case where someone rings the bell and then you haven't put anything on your armor stand or not as much as you could have, you're going to end up losing, because it's not just going to be a case of who ends up winning the game. It's going to be who's first, second, third, and fourth. So even if you know you're not going to win, you still want to go and put down as much armor as you can. And it looks like Fizzy is in the lead so far. I'm going to go and try and get into second place. I'm going to go and put my Stampy style boots down here on this armor stand. Oh, okay. Well, that's... I don't think we've got any chance to compete against William Beaver, do we, to be fair? When he has, like, a full set of diamond armor on him. And whoop, I am getting really hurt now. I think even just taking off those boots, it even does make a little difference like that. But what I want to do is I want to go in the corner. I want to break away this dirt because it's annoying me. And let me show you. Do you see what I mean? Doesn't it kind of look like a bit of a magic cave a little bit? Do you get the star that I'm talking about? So we're going to go and add a few more torches around the outside of the walls there. But apart from that, I think that this room is pretty much done. But this is only the first floor. This is only one part of the game. We are going to go on the roof, and there's going to be a whole nother big section that we're going to be building on the top here, which is where all of the behind the scenes stuff is going to be. And I'll explain exactly how that's all going to work in the next episode. And speaking of the next episode, there will be a link in the description to the next episode once it's online. But for now, I want to thank you all very much for watching, and I will see you all later. Bye!